do you like to read history, particularly Indian history? If yes is your answer, then I'm sure many of you must be fascinated by the Mughal era, the Mughal emperors. Yes, the Mughals were those people who united a large part of India under their rule. Mughals ruled India for many hundreds of years. Mughal architecture, Mughal literature, Mughal food, Mughal music still impact our lives today. Many of us are charmed by Emperor Shah Jahan, Emperor Akbar. But very little has been told or mentioned in books about Mughal empresses, Mughal queens, the harems who used to live during the Mughal era. Now there was one woman who had a wide impact, and she was considered the most powerful Mughal empress of all time. She was born as Mehrunnisa, whom the world came to know as Empress Noorjahan, the 20th wife of Emperor Jahangir, and it was her second marriage to Jahangir. I was very much fascinated by her character, so I read more and more about Noorjahan. So if you want to know about Mughal Empress Noorjahan, then this video is certainly for you. But before beginning this video, let me ask you the same question once again. Can you subscribe my channel Book Tales by Pritha? If you haven't subscribed yet and the subscribe button down below is still red, then press it. Because if you subscribe my channel, you will get the notification whenever I make and post a new video. To know more about Book Tales by Pritha, do follow Book Tales by Pritha on Instagram. The Instagram handle is by the name Book Tales by Pritha. Book Tales by Pritha is also there on Facebook. There is a Facebook group and a Facebook page. Please do like the Facebook page and join the Facebook group and share your opinions on different books. If you are on Twitter and you want to know more about me and Book Tales by Pritha, then the Twitter handle is @PrithaSharkar18. If you want to read my blogs, then it is at prithasnotebook.wordpress.com. All the social media handle link are mentioned in the description below. Also, the books that I mention in my video, I put the link of each of those in the description section. If you want to buy any of the books after watching any of my videos, please buy the books from the link given in the description section. Because if you buy from the link given in the description section, then I get a very small percentage as my commission from the Amazon affiliate link. Now, without further ado, let's begin today's video. Now, in this video, I will talk to you about two books which talks about Empress Noorjahan. The first book is this one, The 20th Wife. The 20th Wife, I have mentioned in one another video also, which I will put the link in the description section as well as somewhere over here. It is a literally masterpiece. Facts have been curbed into fiction and a beautiful storytelling has been done by the author. The 20th Wife is the first book of the Taj trilogy. In this particular book, the author mentions from the birth of Noorjahan, who was considered to be a destiny's child, till she becomes the wife to Emperor Jahangir at her 34th year. She was the 20th wife to Jahangir, and it was her second marriage to Jahangir. Jahangir's last marriage was to Noorjahan. Jahangir made Noorjahan co-sovereign, that is, she was equal in power to Jahangir. Now, this book centers around the character Noorjahan, but definitely the author has mentioned about Noorjahan's family, her brother, her parents. How much impactful and influential were they in Noorjahan's early life, and till her late life, she had a regular communication with her family members, particularly her father, Ghiyas Beg. Next, we also come to know in the backdrop the ruling of Emperor Akbar, Emperor Akbar's relationship with his son Salim, who he fondly called Sheku Baba, the ruling in the court of Akbar and the Mughal Darbar, Emperor Akbar's relationship with his different wives, as well as the equation of Salim with his different wives, mainly the Rajput wives. Also, we come to know about the equation before Noorjahan became the wife of Salim with Salim's family. One of Akbar's wife was extremely fond of Noorjahan. It is under her supervision that Noorjahan became the woman she was. Noorjahan, this name was given to her by Prince Salim or Emperor Jahangir. Also, when Noorjahan was married to Salim, she was the widow to her husband, who was a general in the Mughal army. She had a daughter from her first marriage. Her daughter was named as Ladli Begum. In this book, we also get to know about her relationship with child Shahjahan. The impact that Noorjahan or Mehrunisa had on Shahjahan's early life has been vividly mentioned in this particular book. But I would tell you that if you want to read books with extremely good English literature, then definitely you must read The 20th Wife. Now, the next book that I would like to talk is Empress, The Astonishing Reign of Noorjahan by Ruby Lal. Now, first I read The 20th Wife and then I read this particular book. This book is more, what I felt was more like a history book to me, where there were too many names, too many years that you have to remember while reading the book. This book is more like an autobiography which talks about Noorjahan from her birth till her end. It talks about the encounter of the British traveler who came to visit Emperor Jahangir's court time and again. And time and again, these travelers mentioned about the impact Empress had on the life, of the emperor, as well as the day-to-day workings of the Mughal Darbar. Noorjahan was not only a literate woman, she used to write beautiful poems, she used to go for hunting, she was very rich, well-versed with what is going on in the Mughal Darbar, as Jahangir made her the co-sovereign, a power that was only given to her as a woman during the Mughal rule. She was very much well-versed with day-to-day administration. She was guided by her father, Yaz Beg. It was her brother's daughter, Mumtaz Mahal, who was later married to Shahjahan. So you can understand the influence that was there on Shahjahan's life of his stepmother, Noorjahan. Again, later in the later chapter, we get to know how and why relation between the emperor Salim and Shahjahan gets bitter. Many of the people claim that was because of Noorjahan and because of the high influence that Noorjahan had over the emperor. Noorjahan also had a lot of areas named after her in Kashmir and this was done by her husband Jahangir. Also, we get to know in the later chapter that Jahangir's tomb was made in complete supervision of Noorjahan. Noorjahan did a lot to help the poor and the needy. She was also a patronage of art and culture. In this book, we also see various pictures of Noorjahan, paintings. There is very few paintings of the Mughal women, and one of them may be of Noorjahan. Also, we see how much she knew about, I would say how tactful as an empress she was. Many historians may mark her negatively, but after reading the book, what conclusion I draw was, this woman, Noorjahan, was way, way ahead of her time. She was able to do lot many things during her lifetimes, which women in many generations after her may not be able to think of. So we can say that this woman was extremely strong, powerful and impactful. If you have read any of these two books, that is either The 20th Wife or The Empress, do let me know in the comment section. If after watching my video, you pick to read and choose any of the book, also mention about it in the comment section. What more kind of videos would you like to watch in Book Tales by Pritha? I want to know from you. And for that, you have to comment in the comment section. And if you like this video, please press the like button. Because if you like my video and if you share the video among your friends and relatives, it is only by then I can grow. Also, I forgot to mention that if you ask me to point scores in 5 of these two books, that is Empress and The 20th Wife, I would say I would find it extremely difficult to say how much I would rate it in 5. But if you want to read a book with extremely good language, then I would tell you to read The 20th Wife. But if you want to know about the facts and figures, about books that is telling you the details of different facts that have now we call it history, then go for The Empress. And if you have read any other books on the Mughal era, please mention in the comment section. And I will visit and see you soon in my next video. Till then, tata and bye bye. And do not forget to subscribe Book Tales by Pritha. Thank you for watching this video.